A new report has revealed the number of underinsured Americans has skyrocketed.
This report is a wake-up call for America's leaders. It says we're on the wrong track. We're headed in the wrong direction. Things are getting worse. This is not an isolated problem. This is affecting a broad swath of Americans.
$25 million adults have insurance but lack adequate health care coverage.
The middle class who are worried not only about not having health insurance coverage, but even if they have it, will they be able to afford the care they need if some member of their family gets seriously ill? There's just too much that's left out, too much that families are being asked to pay to give people any sense of economic security.
Here's why.
The basic problem is that healthcare costs have been rising at double-digit rates since 2000, and employers have responded to that rise in costs by shifting more of those costs to workers and their families. And that's taken the form of higher and higher deductibles, so the amount that patients have to pay before their insurance coverage kicks in. So it would have been, say, $250 for a family a decade ago. Today we're talking about $500. Some cases, $1,000, $2,000, before insurance coverage begins to cover anything.
Cathy Schoen of the Commonwealth Fund says there are things policymakers can do to help alleviate the burden for so many underinsured Americans.
At the policy level, what needs to be done to address the problem of the underinsured is to focus on affordability, both when we ask what's the premium someone can afford, and also what benefits are in that policy. We need a national floor under benefits, which says when you buy an insurance policy, it will be protective.
Because the problem of the uninsured and underinsured not only affects low-income Americans, but is becoming a greater problem for middle-income Americans. Over the past 5 years, underinsured rates have nearly tripled for middle-class Americans.
We're definitely seeing that people are alarmed, the insured are alarmed, in virtually every survey, including our own. If you ask people what their pressing economic concerns are, it's their ability to pay for medical care, and that includes the insured. People realize that their policies are not always going to be protective.
Now that this report has highlighted the problems and possible solutions to the problem, it's time to take action.
Insurance design is a critical factor in the picture that we've described in this report. If you were in any other country but the United States, you would never get this story.